Goodness gracious, that is Team Black. Team Black is coached by Buzz Tightrear and Messy Jiggler. So we're gonna have just a quick little bout between these two fine teams. This is the future of Minnesota Roller Girls right here. These fine skaters who practice multiple hours every single week without even being on teams as of yet. But they do travel to various locations, including on April 29th, they'll be down in Iowa City, Iowa, taking on the old Capital City Roller Girls. I think do we look ready? Do we look ready to start this little thing here? No? Yes? No? You're there. Okay, Flip's ready. I don't care about Flip. All right. Whistle blows and we are off. Number 10 on Black as Delilah Diamond has picked up lead jammer status for Team Black. Up on her scoring pass. Score once passes through. Wheelie Nelson made her initial pass through. Wheelie approaches the back of the pack and makes her first scoring pass, picking up 4 points to answer in kind. But Delilah Diamond has also picked up four. So right now it is 8-4 in favor of Team Black as both skaters, both jammers coming up on the end. Diamond calls it off. 0 points that last pass. So we're going to have 8-4 right now in favor of Team Black. Next up, looks like Demoraliza jamming for Team Black up against Captain Cordelia for Team White. Little confusion on the track. There we go. Official timekeeper, Myrtle Combat, raises her hand, blows a whistle, and we're off. Nice drawback by Killer B there. Pulling back Captain Cordelia. And Butsy takes a seat in the zone, knockout zone. Lee Jammer goes to Team Black once again. This time it's Demoraliza. And we have a star pass to Jones Jetpack. As Demoraliza runs through, picks up 4 points. Calls off the jam before Joan Jetpack's able to score any points. And we reset for another jam. Number 75 on Black is Slaughter. Up against the ringer, Freeze Baby, who literally just retired last month from her second retirement from Minnesota Roller Girls. It probably won't be her last. And Freeze Baby, lead jammer. First lead jam for Team White. Over Slaughter, hot on her skates. As Freeze Baby turns off the speed. Calls it off. 2 points scored for Black. 4 points scored for White. So it's 16:50 to go. Team Black leads 15-8. For those of you just joining us, this is a friendly little competition between two teams of our recreational and training league, the Minnesota Roller Girls Debutantes. These are the skaters that hope to be drafted by one of the MNRG home teams. Oh, lead jammer goes to Killer B, Team Black. Classes and no home. brings a single point for Team Black. And a goose egg for Team White. Black 19, White 8. Lila Diamond wearing the Jammer Star for Team Black right now, up against Captain Cordelia, skating for Debutante's Team White. Whistle blows, and here we go. And nice run there by Captain Cordelia, cuts through on the inside. Cordelia through, takes a bit of a tumble, gets right back up, and skates, calls it off. Is it in time? It is. Five big roller derby points scored by Captain Cordelia. That brings White up to 13, a 6-point game. Still in favor of Team Black. Oh, and only 4 points. All right. 4 points scored by Team White there. So it is going to be a... Check back wearing the Jammer Star for Team White up against Demoraliza for Team Black. Demoraliza makes it through first for Lead Jammer, but Joan Jetpack hot on her skates. Power and speed catching up. Team Black bringing Black up to 21 and White to 17. Half to go. Looks like a 4-point game. Black with 21, White with 17. Whistle blows, we're off again. Pitch lap, we're in the Jammer Star, 14 Black. Up against Sugar Beatdown for Team White. In turn two, has a big top four player defense she has to beat. And she cuts around the outside, makes it through. Lead Jammer Sugar Beatdown. Forming the Cal Drop defense up at the front. Zero and zero and null and null and goose egg and goose egg. The score remains the same, 21 to 17. 12 minutes to go in this pre-show game between Team White and Team Black of the Minnesota Roller Girls Debutantes. This is the Recreation and Training League for the Minnesota Roller Girls. Pantera wearing the Jammer Star for Team White up against Killer B for Team Black. Both teams, both skaters made it through. Pantera decides to call it off. number 311, Butsy, wearing the jammer star for Team White. Up against number 75, Slaughter, for Team Black. And it is Butsy who makes it through initially. Is your lead jammer of renown and resort. And it looks like we got a star pass going on to Delilah Diamond, who is now the jammer for Team Black. As Butsy calls it off. Minutes to go, and the score is tied 21 to 21. Joan Jetpack wearing the Jammer Star for Team White. Up against Demoralizer for Team Black. Jammer goes, Team Black, number 480, Demoralizer. And that's five big roller derby points. A grand slam for number 480, Demoralizer, and the black team, which moves them up. Precious, I'm here. Star Stash by Joan Jetpack. And it's called, and two more points are scored by Team Black, bringing them up to 28. That's a 7-point lead with 8.5 to go in this pre-show entertainment. For those of you just joining us, again, this is the Minnesota Roller Girls Debutante Recreation and Training League. Split up into two teams, Team Black and Team White. Captain Cordelia, number 22, wearing the Jammer Star for Team White. Up against number 10, Delilah Diamond for Team Black, who takes the Jammer status. Calls it off after scoring two points. That brings Team Black up to 30. That's a 9-point lead with 7.5 to go. Hey, remember, the after party is over at Tom Reed's Hockey City Pub, just two short blocks away from the Roy / XL / River Center Complex. The All-Stars will be going to the Big O first week of May, weekend of May, out in Oregon. It'll be streamed live. Lead jam goes to Team White. You heard the man. Boom. The Countess up against Killer B, who has also made her initial pass through. Nelson wearing the Jammer Star right now for Team White, number 5-11. He is going up against Slaughter, number 75 for Team Black. 3, maybe 4 jams left in this mini game. Started things off. Slaughter, your lead jammer. Nice tap there by number 10, Delilah Diamond of Team Black. Knocking Wheelie Nelson out of the running. Wheelie had to retreat behind Delilah to avoid getting a track cut penalty. Two points scored by Team Black. That brings them up to 38. It was a tie game at 21 just a few minutes ago. With 5 minutes to go, Team Black has a 13-point lead, 38-25 over Team White. Demoralized, the number 480 is now skating for Team Black as their jammer. Joan Jetpack, number 90 for Team White. Whistle blows, and here we go. And nice, great tightrope walk through. Demoralize a lead jammer. And Black continues to increase their lead 42-25, just over 4 minutes to go. White desperately needs a huge run here, but they got Freeze Baby out there. And Freeze Baby grabs the lead jammer status. Approaching the back, Delilah Diamond trying to catch up through and freezes through. Calls it off. Freeze Baby picked up, I believe, 4 points. Yep, 4 points scored by Freeze Baby to bring Team White up to 29. So it is a 13-point game with 3 minutes to go, two, possibly three more jams in this game. Whistle blows, and once again, we are off. Kid Vicious finally wearing the jammer star for Team Black, and Joe Jetpack takes lead jammer for Team White. Big roller derby points. Three, count them, 3 points separate these two teams right now. Jetpack, cut to the inside, calls it off. Picks up four. So White takes the lead by 1 point. With 1 minute 40 seconds remaining, this would probably be our last jam. So we have a 1 point game in our pre-show. How about that? Whistle blows and we are off. Number 75 for Team Black is Slaughter, but your lead jammer once again, Captain Cordelia for Team White. Four points scored. That brings White up to 47. So a 5 point lead, but there's still a minute left to go in playtime. The jam can go for up to 2 full minutes. We'll see what happens here. Star Stash. By Slaughter. Took off the star, but did not ruin it. All right. So it looks like we are going to start the last gym with about 3 seconds to go. So that means we can have a full gym, a full two-minute gym, even after period time has expired. Jammers in this last jam here, number 480. Demoraliza for Team Black, and for Team White. Both teams initially made it through. Team White calls it. And that is a Team White win coming from behind to take the victory. Congratulations to Team White of the Debutantes. If you would like to join the Debutantes, there is no minimum skill requirement. Just a positive attitude and willingness to learn. You can check out mnrollergirls.com for more information on becoming a Minnesota Roller Girls debutante. All right, folks, we are going to get started in just about five minutes. So make sure you head on over to the concession stand or a bar to get yourself a tasty beverage, a hat bag, one of them soft pretzels you love so much. Also, the merch stand is open. If you'd like to pick up a MNRG t-shirt or a Philly t-shirt, Philly did bring merch as well. Well, we will get started in just about 5 minutes, folks.
Yeah. All right, how many of you here tonight are watching Derby for the very first time? Awesome, awesome. We are so excited to have you here tonight. You got a little taste of what it looks like with our Debutantes Roller Girls League. Oh, there we are. So they're going to do a play-by-play. If we're going to do a 101 if you've just walked in. My name is Stalker Channing. Welcome to the legendary Roy Wilkins Auditorium. We are so happy to have you here to kick off our All-Star season tonight. Roller Derby is played with two teams on the track. Here we have a team in black and a team in white. The greatest number of skaters at one time is called the pack. Pack, give us a wave. Pack has to be made up of players from both teams, and they have to be skating within a close proximity of each other. You'll notice that two skaters have stripes down their helmets, their rain helmet covers. Those are the pivots. Pivots, give us a wave. Pivots often direct the strategy of their play, and they are the only people that can receive a star pass from our jammers. Jammers, give us a wave. You'll see they have stars on their helmets. Jammers are the only skaters that can score points. I'm gonna pretend I have a whistle. So the pack is released with one whistle. The first skater through the pack cleaning, the first jammer, is going to be called lead jammer. You'll notice that her ref points at her. She can call off the jam at any time prior to its natural conclusion after 2 minutes. So she can call it off before using strategy. Now she's on her scoring pass. She's gonna score 1 point for every opposing player she passes cleanly. The lead jammer may then call off the jam by touching her hands to her hips. She touches her hands to the hips, the referees blow their whistles, and that's how we know that this jam has ended. Here we would see that the jammer in black would have scored 4 points for these skaters in white, and you would see that the jammer in white passed the hips of this player in black, so she would score 1 point. Now there's a lot more to this game. It's gonna go fast, there's gonna be a lot of hitting, and there are penalties. So keep your eyes open, look in the programs, and if you see any of these ladies in the audience, feel free to ask them questions. Welcome, and thank you, Debutantes.
Yes. Yes, Debutantes, excellent. Okay. Are we ready for this?
I think we are ready for this.
Are you ready for this? Okay.
Yeah?
Because tonight, we have two bouts for you.
Two.
First up, the Philly Block Party takes on the Minnesota Nice. And then we got Black Market Brass playing.
How cool is that?
And after that, the number 14 in the world, Philly Liberty Bells, take on the number 10 in the world, Minnesota Roller Girls All-Stars.
There we go. How exciting is that? Welcome to the kickoff of All-Star season.
But we have some rules for you people.
You are not exempt.
For you people. Rule number one, trackside seating is at your own risk. Roller Girls can and will fly off the track and into your lap. However, if a Minnesota Roller Girl lands in your lap, you cannot take her home.
You wouldn't want to. She smells. Like
smells
badly.
Super bad. Super
badly.
Bad.
Second rule, do not step on the track outside of halftime, where you are more than welcome to come down and dance to the sounds of Black Market Brass.
All right. Rule number three, you are not allowed to touch or grab roller girls or mascots at any time. Not only might it mess up the game, but it's also uncouth.
Uncouth. Yes. Number four, by entering the legendary Roy Wilkins Auditorium, you agree to the possibility of being filmed by any number of people for any number of reasons.
Oh, boy.
It'll end up on the internet.
And rule number five, of course, the most important rule of all, the one that we drill into children at an early
very
age.
Very early age.
So what they hit, the magic age of 21, they are ready to chant it along with all of you. Rule number five, one, two, three.
Don't spill your beer.
Absolutely not, folks. Welcome to the Roy Wilkins. Let's get ready to roll.